Hello everyone. Last time we read about economical importance of bacteria in the medicines. Today let us learn about their role in industries and agriculture. It is not module 1. By mistake it has come there. It is module 2. Okay, so now let's move ahead. So how these bacteria help us in agriculture? The bacteria which lives in the root nodules of leguminous plants is called the rhizobium, which converts the free nitrogen into soluble nitrates. So we'll learn this nitrogen ka thing in detail afterwards. First let's know the next point. It is solid bacteria like the Azotobacter and the Clostridium converts nitrogen into ammonia. The solid bacteria which are there, that is Azotobacter and Clostridium, this converts nitrogen into ammonia. Ammonia ka formula is what? NH3. And nitrogen ka N2. So they had hydrogen to it and ammonia is created. Ammonia is good for soil and therefore a fertility of soil is increased. Fertility of soil is increased, crop will be good. So in this way it helps in agriculture. How are these helpful in industry? It can be used in curing of tea. These bacteria are treated with tea leaves so that the different flavors are created of these tea leaves. Okay, a different flavor of teas are created. So this is done. Now, so different flavors of tea are created and different aromas of tea are getting if we introduce these bacteria. This is called as curing of tea, the curing of tea, some people say it as. Next is tanning of leather. As we know that the bacteria after if some substance, living substance which is dead now, and if you keep it like that only, the part of it also, if you keep it like that only, the bacteria acts on it. Okay, so it decomposes. But you know, these tanning of leather is also done by these bacteria only. The treating of skin, you know, leather is formed by the skin of animal. So the skin of animal is taken off. But you know what? This will be want soft leather. You can't just take however it is there, all that fleshy thing and all that. So we don't want that. So what we do is we treat bacteria. The bacteria we add to it. Now this bacteria, what it does, it, you know, it eats up, it decomposes the perishable part so that a nice soft leather remains. This leather is further used. So in this way bacteria is used in tanning of leather. Now as I told you before, the nitrogen ka thing. Now let's learn about that role of nitrifying bacteria, which is also called as the nitrogen cycle. This process is also called as the nitrogen cycle. You can see it in the beside. Nitrification also it is called as. So first, what happens? First step is that the plants need. We all know that the plants need nitrogen. Okay, but for photosynthesis, nitrogen is also needed. Of course, it's not in the reaction because slight amount might be needed, and also for some other uses. It should get all the nutrients, one of them being nitrogen for this photosynthesis of proteins. But you know, it cannot use direct nitrogen in the atmosphere. It is not perfect for them. It has to be created in soluble nitrates. This direct atmosphere made what nitrogen is there, no? It cannot be absorbed by the plants. Okay, now people say why it cannot be absorbed by the plants. Plants should absorb nitrogen na directly. If they want this nitrogen, nahi to nahi milega. No, it is not like that. If someone tells you you eat paper and live on paper, are you going to live on paper? No, you can't. Therefore, you have other things. But if you tell a cow to eat paper, yes, she can eat paper. You know. So it's like that. Plants cannot directly take nitrogen, so they have another methods to take this nitrogen. It has to be converted into soluble nitrates, then only these plants can take in nitrogen. So what happens is, it is obtained in the form of soluble nitrates, as we all know, which is absorbed by the soil of the roots. So leaves cannot directly take nitrogen, so it has to come from the soil of the roots. Soil of the root mein kahan se jayega? Let's see. The nitrates are replenished in soil by the bacteria through the process of nitrification. Let's learn this nitrification process. The bacteria converts nitrogenous waste of animals. We all know the animals also have some nitrogenous waste in it. So when an animal dies, you know, its remains are in the ground. So this whatever remains in the nitrogenous waste is gone. The bacteria converts that nitrogenous waste into ammonia. Okay, ammonia can be directly used, but you know we want nitrogen. हम लोग को ammonia नहीं चाहिए, nitrogen चाहिए. So now what this ammonia has to be done is that this ammonia is converted to ammonium. Ammonia का क्या formula? NH3. Ammonium NH4. This ammonium compound is formed. Now this ammonium compound is converted into nitrites. Nitrite क्या होता है? NO2. नाइट्राइट में कन्वर्ट कौन करता है इसको? नाइट्रोसोमोनास बैक्टीरिया. एंड ये नाइट्रोसोमोनास बैक्टीरिया के कन्वर्ट करने के बाद जो नाइट्राइट इज रिमेनिंग, दैट नाइट्राइट इज देन कन्वर्टेड टू नाइट्रेट बाय द नाइट्रोबैक्टर. नाउ द डीनाइट्रिफाइंग बैक्टीरिया विच इज प्रेजेंट इन द सॉइल, इट ब्रेक्स डाउन द सॉइल नाइट्रेट्स to release nitrogen gas. So if these soil nitrates are not needed, denitrifying bacteria release the nitrogen gas. But whenever this is needed, plants take it in. Jitna chahiye plant ko utna hi lega. But jitna nahi chahiye, it will be remaining like that only. Waste to hone nahi denge kuch. So it spreads nitrogen gas in the atmosphere. Let's move ahead. What type of industries may these bacteria can be used? As we know, we learned about the tea ka thing. Then synthesis of vitamins can be done by this. For making biogas plants, also these bacteria are used. Also for preservation of food, bacteria are used. First, let's learn just some things. What is this botulism? Between me only, kya this botulism I have taken. Botulism is a very, very serious kind of food poisoning due to a special type of bacteria. It's related to bacteria, so it's being taken in the chapter. So this Clostridium botulinum is the bacteria which creates this botulism, which is very serious food poison. Now this is usually found in tinned and sealed food. Therefore you are advised that you should not take tinned and sealed food. And if you are taking, you should check it neatly. The expiry date you should check neatly. And also you have to check if the seal and the tin is properly sealed. It's not open from any side or torn on. If it's torn, you should never take these bacteria, this food, because it can have bacteria in it and it can cause food poisoning. So you should never do that. Methods of food preservation. You know that bacteria also spoils the food sometimes. So if you want to prevent this food from getting polluted by bacteria, you have to do some preservations of the methods of these food preservation. First is boiling or heating at very high temperature. If you heat something at very high temperature, if you boil that, you know, the bacteria dies. Therefore, it said that you should boil water and drink or any food, you should cook neatly and then you should eat so that the bacteria gets killed. Salting or preserving fish pickles. Fish pickles only not, but there are many things which are salted so that they are not getting this. After adding you salt, you know, the bacteria is getting killed. The salt kills the bacteria. So, you know, after killing these bacteria, the food can be remaining for a much time. Next is dehydration of drying food. So, whenever water is there, you know, the bacteria can come and it can drink. For the water, it comes and pollutes the food. So if you don't want the bacteria to come to the food, you know, all the water is removed from the food. You can see these strawberries. First they were all red, fleshy, full, very thick. Now the water is removed, so they have become very dryish and all the water is removed. Dehydration takes place. Next is irradiations by treating UV rays or gamma rays. Okay, these UV and gamma rays, you know, are very strong light rays which can kill actually the bacteria or fungi, that is mold or spores of bakeries. Then pasteurization. This is a special technique of sterilizing milk. By, you know, what happens is first they heat milk a lot and suddenly they cool. This what happens is the bacteria gets killed. Refrigeration under very cold temperature. In this also bacteria cannot grow. it freezes, so the bacteria cannot grow, it dies. So when you say that you should not keep the food on open, if you want to preserve it for some days, you should keep it in fridge, because in fridge temperature is cold, bacteria cannot live. The next is that strong concentration of chemicals, you know, can also kill bacteria. We all know this very well. Let's go ahead. There are bacterial diseases also which can be caused. In plants, the bacterial blight of the cowpea takes place, which when in this what happens is that the vegetable which is there, you know, it rots and becomes black in color due to the action of bacteria. In animals, you know, anthrax swelling takes place of the body, which can reduce the milk yield if it is a cattle. Or tuberculosis takes place, where lungs are affected by dry husky cough takes place, as you can see in the picture. Then in humans, it can create many diseases like whooping cough, diphtheria, tetanus, cholera, typhoid, pertussis, tuberculosis, pneumonia, and many much diseases. We'll be learning about diseases also soon, but for now, just brush up. Now, these bacteria can also be used in bioweapons. What is bioweapons? Bioweapons are known as the germ warfare, you know, where actually with this bacteria or the biological substances like the living matter, you know, it is reacted to make a strong disease, okay, and it is spread in the another country, so that the the people are killed in there due to that disease and all. So of course you must be thinking, this COVID-19, is it a bioweapon? Yeah, I guess it is a bioweapon which is produced by China to destroy the economical self of the whole world. So of course I hope this coronavirus ends soon. You all know the story of this actually coronavirus, how it was created. Okay, we don't know now what is there. Now, if it has come, we should be living with it now. We should be comfortable living with all this lockdown and coronavirus now. So, you know, what happens is the use of biological toxins and infection agents such as bacteria, viruses and fungi, which is there, no? They are made with intent to kill the incapacitated humans. Okay, so these animals or plants which act as the war act of war, the germ bombs are exploited, so it can cause a very dangerous epidemic. Of course, this was not done like that. It is said to be leaking out. This bio warfare is completely banned in the whole world, but although I don't know why this China is this. No, we can't do it. So with this, we have completed the chapter. In the next module, we also have to learn about fungi. So we'll learn about fungi in the next one. Thank you.